Warren Buffett says, come fly with me. In his largest takeover ever, Warren has agreed to buy aerospace supplier Precision Castparts for $32 billion. Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway has agreed to pay $235 per share. That is a 21% premium from Precision's closing price on Friday. If you take a look right now at shares of Precision Castparts, they're not quite there yet. They're not at $235. They are jumping 19% on the news, but still at around $231. Now, perhaps that suggests that Warren Buffett did not at least underpay for the company. Just what does Precision Castparts do that convinced the Oracle of Omaha to pay that kind of price? Well, it builds forged components and airfoil castings, are you with me, for aircraft engines, and it also builds assemblies for aerospace, transportation, and power generation. Some of its biggest customers include Airbus, Boeing, GE, and Rolls-Royce. And you can see Boeing is getting a very nice punch on this, up 2.5%. And Rolls-Royce Group is also up about 1.5%. GE up 1.75%. Airbus lower just fractionally. What will Precision add to the Berkshire Hathaway portfolio of more than 80 companies? And why is that so special? Well, let's ask, because joining me now on the phone is Oracle of Omaha, as he's known, Berkshire Hathaway Chairman and CEO Warren Buffett. Warren, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Hi, Liz.
How many Cherry Cokes have you had to celebrate this massive deal?
I have about five a day, so I'm not sure exactly where I stand now.
Well, I would say you're probably celebrating in some way or another, but our viewers have been questioning, you know, day by day whether the bull market's coming to a slow end, and boom, you go ahead and make this huge bet. So they're very interested in your thinking. What is so special about Precision Castparts?
Well, it's a company making very important parts for very important machines, namely aircraft. So it, as you mentioned, it's a supplier to those companies you name: Boeing, GE, United Technologies, Rolls-Royce. And the company is just extraordinarily good at making some very complicated, sometimes highly technical parts. And they're the most reliable supplier you can have, and if you're putting an aircraft together, you want to be sure you've got the right parts coming at the right time.
Well,
and
yeah, there's that moat of entry. You know, it's too hard to just start up that kind of company, right?
I would not want to go compete with them. That's my test.
You've owned the stock for 3 years. I have to know, were you licking your chops over those 3 years to buy it outright for that long, or was there a lightning bolt moment more recently?
Yeah, Todd Combs, who manages money for us, he's been with us about 5 years. He manages $9 billion. He's owned the stock for about 3 years. And so you got to give him credit for the deal. I had not really paid any attention to the company before he brought my attention to it. And so over the last 3 years, he's educated me on it. I followed it. And then, 5 or 6 weeks ago, the CEO and the CFO and the IR person came in. But yeah. The person, Mark Donegan, who runs it enormously, impressed me when I dropped in on the meeting he was having. And so we made a bid, and they took it.
They took it. And he's going to continue to run it because that's how you roll. You buy companies, right? And you like how they're run.
If he didn't look healthy to me and I didn't figure he's going to run it for another 30 years, I would not have been interested.
Okay, so he probably works out and looks healthy.
he's a much healthier guy than I am. I'm very impressed with him.
Look, it does get some of its revenues from the energy industry. As he's going to run it, will Greg Abel, your guy in charge of Berkshire Energy and all the companies under that roof, have a role perhaps in overseeing any part of Precision?
No, not at all. No. Mark has done extremely well without anybody overseeing him except his board of directors, and he doesn't need our help. We need his help.
To the naked eye of Buffett watchers, Warren, who love to game why you do things, this also looks like a play on the real belief in the future of the airline industry. Is that part of your thinking?
Well, we certainly believe in the airline industry or our aircraft industry over the next, you name it, 100 years, and we love the... You know, it's a big business. This company is a vital part of it. It's going to be a vital part of it 50 years from now. We love participating in it.
Well, I bring that up because the Chinese middle class is flying a lot more, and airlines there are making purchases from Airbus and Boeing, two of Precision's big clients. Are you worried at all, or do you look at something like that, the slowdown in China currently, that it might hurt the profits, at least in the short term, and are you ready to absorb that?
Well, we don't... We are not buying this to hold it for 6 months or 6 years. We're planning to hold it forever. So we don't really look at the short-term outlook in terms of making decisions on stocks or businesses. We didn't have a discussion of that. When our board talked about it, the short-term outlook, it's not a subject of discussion.
Well, that's a good lesson to, I think, a lot of our viewers who we hope are in it for the long term. Don't do this tick-by-tick mishigas, this insanity, you know, because if you look at how you've really run your business, and yet people are looking at least over the past year and they see that the oil industry has slowed down. You know, 20% or so of Precision's profits come from the oil and gas industry, which is sort of struggling with the bust part of the boom and bust cycle. Do you anticipate the slowdown there lasting much longer?
I really don't know, Liz. I know it isn't going to last forever, but I have no idea whether it'll last 6 months or 2 years.
Doesn't
or 3 years.
Doesn't sound like you care either, at least for
No, I really don't. I mean, if you find a good business run by a terrific manager and you can make it a deal at a reasonable price, you do it. And you don't pay any attention to what astrologers are saying or anybody else.
Astrologers, astronomers. As early as next month, the House might vote, though, to lift the longtime ban on oil exports. Do you look at something like that and how it might affect the energy part of Precision's business?
Not really. Now, there'll be all kinds of developments over time. But somebody that does a terrific job of delivering vital parts, you know, to aircraft manufacturers around the world is going to have a good business over time.
Though, as I look at what the House may or may not do, and we don't know, of course, but I can remember Charlie Munger, your vice chair, telling me once that he thought it was, quote, and I know it doesn't shock you to hear that Charlie would say that it was stupid, his words, stupid to use up our resources and that we should hoard them in a way instead and use up the bad guys' oil overseas so they'd be beholden to us. You know, do you think that that we should continue to not export our precious resources or make some money off it and help our country?
No, Charlie and I agree on that, but we're in a very distinct minority. But we think if we were planning the future of the United States for the next 500 years and we had a finite, an unknown amount of oil and gas, but a finite amount, and we were a very rich country, we would say use the other guys for a long time and, you know, and take advantage of our strength by not using up our natural resources at a fast pace. But like I say, we're in a minority on that.
Money is cheap right now. You borrowed, what, $10 billion to finance part of this deal?
Well, we're contemplating that, Liz. Okay. I mean, we haven't set it in motion yet because it'll take some time for this deal to close. They do business in a lot of countries.
Okay.
And we need to get
approval.
So
that's not a sure thing that you'll borrow?
Exactly what we borrow is not has not been finalized, but I anticipate that we will probably borrow about $10 billion of the $33.
Because money is so cheap right now. You know, in February, you told me it would be hard for, if you were running the Federal Reserve, to tighten rates this year, but Janet Yellen seems to be on course to do it. If she does in September, would that change whether you borrow $10 billion to finance the deal?
No, it really won't. I mean, it wouldn't. She won't change it that much if they do change. But no, that whether rates are what they are now or a half a point higher or a point higher will not that will not change. The main thing we want to decide is how much cash we want to have left around.
Do you anticipate we will see higher rates?
Well, someday we will, but they'll probably raise them faster than I would raise them. But what we hear from a good many Fed governors, at least what I've read, sounds like they are going to raise them. But I have no notion on that. I've never talked to Janet Yellen in my life.
But she'd be interesting to talk to, I think, for all of us.
Exactly. Well, if you get any word from her, pass it on to me.
What's a pressure cooker standpoint. But overall, Warren, as we look at Berkshire Hathaway, this is a company over 50 years, and we were there for your 50th anniversary shareholder meeting that has made many investors hundreds of millions of dollars if they got in early. You know, that must be very gratifying for you, but you're turning 85 in 3 weeks or so. First of all, happy birthday, but
oh, thank you.
You're not slowing down at all. I mean, Neil Cavuto and I were talking about you in the last hour, and you're saying, what is he thinking? He just doesn't slow down.
It's the cherry coke. I feel terrific.
Well, we appreciate you coming on to talk about all of this, and we'll be watching this Precision Castparts deal very closely. At the moment, the stock now at $231.35. So since we've been talking, it went up a little bit.
Okay, well, it's good to talk to you, Liz. Thanks.
Nice to have you. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway Chairman and CEO. By the way, Berkshire stock down just incrementally, barely down just a little bit.